universe declares your majesty.
Come on,
who can compare with such honor?
The Power of Truth coming to you from ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA, every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. Join the Minister of God, Pastor I.G. Fakunle, the Apostolic Church Area Superintendent, Ilesha, Osun State, Nigeria. For inquiries, call this number, +234-906-481-1278, +234-906-481-1278. Remember, it is every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. on ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA. Jesus is Lord.
Our God is such a wonderful God. Very interesting to serve Him. You can never serve Him and regret, because He will always send help from above. When you are in need, when you think that you can no longer make it, my God is the God of great surprises. As I was telling you last week, this same God sent help from above to Joshua, and He gave him four great promises which enabled him to carry out the duty assigned to him. Today, I know that God has a purpose for your life, and I know that where you are worshiping, you have not been pulling your weight, because you are being pulled down by certain forces. But today, I am going to speak on help from above. You will receive help from above, and you will get up on your legs. Come with me to the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. John, chapter 5. I want to read from verse 5 to 8. Now, a certain man was there who had an infirmity 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there, and knew that he already had been in that condition a long time, he said to him, "Do you want to be made well?" The sick man answered him, "Sir, I have no man to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up, but while I am coming, another steps down before me." Jesus said to him, "Rise, take up your bed, and walk." Help from above. There are two people who needed help. This is the first one. In John chapter 5, the Bible said for 38 years, this man had been lying there at the pool called Bethesda, the house of mercy. For 38 years, mercy excluded him. Not that he didn't try, he tried. But those who are more agile than him, and those who have people who can help him, because the Bible said an angel comes down once in a year to stir the water, and whoever comes in first after the stirring of the water shall be healed of any disease. But this man was helpless. His families have neglected him for 38 years. Jesus came to his aid. Another person was in Acts of the Apostles chapter 3, a lame man who was born lame, and for over 40 years he had been carried as a beggar to beg alms from people who are entering the church, who are entering the synagogue, who are entering the temple. For over 40 years, nobody could help him. He remained a beggar, but Jesus helped him. One may be in the right place, but without right connection. These two people, they were in the right place, but they don't have the right connection. They were not connected. And so they were struggling on their own, and their puerile effort cannot yield anything positive. You see, people like that are in perpetual suffering. They are always in trouble. They are always in sorrow. And their sorrow will continue until they receive help from above. Maybe as you are listening to me now, there is somebody in that category very, very near to you. You also may be in that category. You have been grappling with certain problems for many years. Even those problems have been there before you were born. Maybe it was inherited in your family, and everybody was taking it as if it was normal. But God has declared it as an abnormality in your life. You will receive help from above today. Every power that has been militating against you, the Lord will remove them in the mighty name of Jesus. God said there is victory in sight for you. But it is one thing to see victory in sight. It's another thing to seize it. You see, these two people, they saw victory in sight and seized it. The Bible said Jesus came before this man, and he was listening to Jesus. He paid attention to Jesus, and Jesus asked him, "Do you want to be healed?" He was giving excuses, but he had his eyes fixed on Jesus. Because he did not remove his eyes from Jesus, Jesus Christ said, "Whether you have somebody or not, I come to help you. Take up your bed and go." The same thing, the second man. The Bible said he fixed his eyes on Peter and John, expecting to receive something. You see, you need not only see your opportunity, you must learn to seize your opportunity. It is very important. You see, Jesus is the helper of the helpless. Bethesda means house of mercy. It is very, very surprising that this man was sitting at Bethesda for 38 years asking for mercy, and nobody gave him. That is the difference between the Jesus I am telling you. The very day Jesus Christ visited that place, he showed him mercy. Whatever has been delay you from receiving mercy, the Lord God will open the door of mercy for you today in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to show you what are those things Jesus Christ did for this man. The two of them, the one in John chapter 5 and the one in Acts chapter 3, the Bible did not give us their names. See, what does that mean? It can happen to anybody. what happened to them can happen to anybody, and that what God did for them, he can do for anybody who trusted him, who believed in him. If you believe in God today, I want to let you understand that my Jesus is merciful. He will have mercy upon you. Number one, the first thing Jesus Christ did was to restore this man into fellowship with God. He restored his relationship to God in John chapter 5 and verse 5. Now, a certain man was there who had infirmity 38 years. A certain man. That means this man was known to Jesus. And Jesus purposely went to that place because of that man. How do I know that? Go and read your Bible. The Bible said there are many people who are blind, the him, the Lord, their halt. Immediately Jesus healed this man. He did not heal any other person. He left. You see, he restored this man's fellowship with God. He linked this man with God. That is what my Jesus Christ can do for you. He can link you with your Creator. You know, I was telling you some weeks ago when I was preaching on Jesus, the same yesterday, today, and forever, that he is the only mediator, the one who can stand between us and God. If you will fix your gaze upon the Lord Jesus Christ, the fellowship you have lost with your Creator, the relationship that has been marred between you and your Creator, Jesus will rebuild it. And when that relationship is rebuilt, whatever you have lost, you shall regain them. Nobody with any infirmity can enter the temple. You see? Nobody. In Acts of the Apostles chapter 3, the man had been there for 40 years. Why? Because he was lame. And by law, he must not enter. If he entered, they would kill him. But when he was healed, he entered into the temple. Jesus restored the relationship with God. And that is the first thing you need to do in your life. The strained relationship between you and God, allow Jesus Christ, by admitting him into your heart, to mend that strained relationship, so that you can be one with your God, so that you can worship God the way he wanted. Number two, Jesus separated him from the company of the impotent. You see, in John chapter 5, verse 3, in this lay a great multitude of sick people, blind, lame, paralyzed, waiting for the moving of the water. You see that? The same thing with Acts chapter 3. You see, the man was in the company of beggars. In fact, he has turned his junior brothers who were carrying him every day to beggars like himself. But what did Jesus Christ do? He separated them from the company of impotent people. That word impotent means somebody who is powerless. See, and I was telling you in the powers you must have about 2 weeks ago. See, the power to pray with God, the power of the word of God, the power to be able to reap out of your labor, things like that, you need it. That was what Jesus Christ did. Jesus went to this man and raised him. He was no longer a companion of the blind, the lame, the weak anymore. He took his bed, the home he had left for 38 years, he went back, not as a beggar, but as a man made whole. As you are listening to me now, I want you to understand that irrespective of the condition you are, maybe you have been told that your limbs are bad, you can never use your limbs again, that your hand cannot be stretched again, that you will never be able to walk again. That is man's conclusion. God's conclusion is carry your bed and walk. When you attach yourself to the Lord Jesus, when you activate your faith in the Lord Jesus, telling Jesus there is nothing you cannot do. I want you to understand one thing today. The only person who can tell me that you cannot be healed, or that your matter cannot be settled, is anybody who can convince me that when God created you, he did not create you in his image? And nobody can do that. And the Bible said when God created you in his image, he declared everything good. So if any badness come into your life, it was after your creation, not before your creation. In other words, it was not the doing of God. And if God did not do it, then he can undo what Satan or anybody has done in your life. Let that be your faith. If that is your faith, I am telling you, there is nothing God cannot do. Number three, Jesus supplied what he could not get with physical strength. See, in John chapter 5, verses 4 and 7, look at what it says. John chapter 5 and verse 4. The Bible said, "For an angel went down at a certain time into the pool and stirred up the water. Then whoever stepped in first, after the stirring of the water, was made well of whatever disease he had." You see, this man needed the physical strength to be able to run ahead of other people to enter the pool to be healed. But where is the strength? He didn't have it. You see, in verse 7, the Bible said, "The sick man answered him, 'Sir, I have no man to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up. But while I am coming, another step down before me.'" You see that? Let me tell you one thing today. Jesus Christ can fill the vacuum in your life. Every vacuum created by your enemies in your life so that you will not get help at the right time, Jesus Christ can fill that space. He can fill that vacuum. He can be to you what no father can be to you. He can be to you what no doctor can be to you. He can be to you what no attorney can be to you, because he is pleading your case before God. You see, it is not by strength or by power, but by the Spirit of the Lord. That is why we sing, "It's not by might, it's not by power, but by my Spirit, says the Lord. This mountain must be removed. This mountain must be removed. This mountain has been removed by my Spirit, says the Lord." That is what God wants you to know today. Irrespective of the hopelessness of your condition, my Jesus will give you hope where there is no hope. He will not only give you hope, he will do what no man can do for you. If you like him, if you release yourself to him, nobody carried this man. Jesus Christ said, "You don't need anybody to carry you. Carry your bed, go home." Where did the strength come from? From Jesus. Where did the healing come from? From Jesus. The Bible said, "By his stripes we were healed." As you are listening to me, anywhere you are now, I am praying with the authority of God that the strength of God will enter into your limb and you start to use and you start to do what you have been unable to do in the name of Jesus. So, that's what Jesus Christ did. Number four, Jesus spoke to his problems and they disappeared. You see, Jesus spoke to the problem of this man. Jesus said to him, "Rise, take up your bed and walk." Do you know that your problems, your sickness, they have ears? Do you know that they are spiritual entities? Those things you call problems, those things you call sickness, they are spiritual entities. They have ears. And when God speaks to them, they must obey. So whatever is your problem, as you are listening to me now, in the name of Jesus, they will hear the voice of God and they will leave your body in the mighty name of Jesus. They will leave your marriage in the name of Jesus. They will leave your brain in the name of Jesus. They will leave your cord in the name of Jesus. They will leave your eyes. They will leave every part of your body and you will regain the use of your body right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Number 5, he gave him rest. You see that? In that verse 9, see, and immediately the man was made well, took up his bed and walked. Jesus Christ, he gave him rest. He was no longer to be ridiculed by the society. He was no longer labeled disabled. You see that? He gave him rest from mockery. He gave him rest from anything evil. And that is what my Jesus Christ is going to do for you. I want you to understand that with God, all things are possible. Because if you understand what I'm saying here, you, the forgotten man, these two people, the one at Bethesda, he was forgotten. His family is neglected. The one at the beautiful gate, he was forgotten. Nobody ever believed that he can be healed anymore. You see? But when Jesus stepped in, he remembered them. Whatever is your problem, I want you to understand that my Jesus will remember you. He will remember that he created you. He will remember that he went to the cross because of you. He will remember that he died because of you. He will remember that he resurrected because of you. He will remember that he was mediating for you before God. And when Jesus Christ remembers all that, he says, whatever you shall ask the Father in my name, he will do. That is why, as you are listening to me now, I want to challenge you. Don't listen to any voice in you telling you that you will remain in that your poor condition of health, poor condition of employment, poor condition of status, poor condition of life. No! No! All you need to do is to fix your gaze on Jesus and let Jesus Christ know that you don't trust any other person other than him, that your life is hidden in him, and that with Jesus Christ in your life, you are more than conquerors. That is what I want you to confess. Don't confess anything negative. Don't confess any problem. I've listened to many people, they say, oh, this problem is too much for me. What do you mean by that? They can be too much for you. But when you bring God to your side, they are not too much for God. The Bible says, my God is able to do much more than we have requested. You see, God will even go the extra mile to give you what you did not even expect. Do you remember what he did for Joseph? You see, Joseph did not ask for wife, he was given. He did not ask for house, he was given. He did not ask for car, he was given. He did not ask for servants, they were given to him. The same thing, let me tell you, you are honorable before God if God is honorable in your life. That is it. God will be to you what he is to you. That's it. If God is honorable in your life, he will not leave you dishonorable. No. If you believe God that God is strong in your life, he will not leave you vulnerable. No. If you believe that God is rich in your life, he will not leave you poor. No. Your view of God will determine what he will do for you. That is why, whatever you want to receive from God, give God your heart. When you give God your heart, when you give God your life, the Bible said, whatever you shall ask, it shall be done for you in my name by my Father. I am a living witness to that. There are many times God has delivered me when I was face to face with death. There are times when God has operated upon me. You see, I am a living witness to that. What I am telling you is one of the things I've experienced in my own life. That is why I am bold to tell you that Jesus Christ is able. Is able to help you. Is able to liberate you. Is able to bless you. But you know what? You need to fix your eyes on Jesus. You need to fix your gaze on him. And when you fix your eyes upon him, the Bible says, nothing good will be withheld from those who walk upright. And you know what? The hand of Jesus Christ's right hand is ready to pull you up so that you will not wobble in your way back to God. The Bible said, I will uphold you with my right hand of righteousness. And when God upholds you, nobody can bring you down. Father, I want to thank you. I want to glorify you because you are God. Those who may be listening to me now, and people have abandoned them to their problems, to the sicknesses in their body, to the problems of life. In fact, they have become very, very notorious to people. When people see them, they want to avoid them because they are tired of helping them. Father, these two people today, which you asked me to place before your people, they have become burdens to the family, and the families are tired. All those who are listening to me now, come to their help in the name of Jesus. Raise them up from their sick bed in the name of Jesus. Raise them up by meeting their needs, their daily need in the mighty name of Jesus. And finally, their need for salvation, meet it so that they will reign with you eternally. I want to bless you for what you have done. In Jesus' name I've prayed. Amen. Amen. May the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.
This is the Power of Truth coming to you from ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA, every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. Join the Minister of God, Pastor I.G. Fakunle, the Apostolic Church Area Superintendent, Ilesha, Osun State, Nigeria. For inquiries, call this number, +234-906-481-1278, +234-906-481-1278. Remember, it is every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. on ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA. Jesus is Lord.